Welcome, folks. A very good morning, a very good day, and a very good evening to you. I'm Sumit, the architect of StatCraft, and in this short video, I'll show you how to import data into StatCraft. StatCraft can get data from either of two sources, CSV files or Excel spreadsheets. In this video, I'll walk you through the process of reading data from CSV files. Now, reading data into StatCraft from a CSV file is very easy. You need to go to this menu at the corner, which you know is normally referred to as a hamburger menu. Click on it, and from the drop-down, click on Data. From the panel that opens up, click Import. You will be taken to this screen. Now, on the left-hand side, you will notice these two fields. And let me explain this to you. Now, if I try to upload a file and click on this upload file, you will see that I get an error message. This is because StatCraft stores the data in database tables. So even before you start to upload the file, you must provide a table name with which StatCraft can store the data inside. So if you go here and start typing a name that you like, let's call it Iris. Now you can see something here. If I type I, it gives a message table already exists. So you cannot call this table I. So let's try Iris. Okay, but that's I think I type IR. So let me try from beginning. I'll call this table my underscore Iris. Okay, this is because I have already stored that Iris data, which is available in R as an example data set already in a CSV file. And here I provide a description of this table so that whenever I am looking into my data later, I can remember what I have done. So here I just write my Iris data. And that is all. Then I click on upload file. Now my files are loaded on my desktop. So here you can see this Iris file, and I open this. Next you see the screen. Now if you see, there are five columns that I'm presented with: variable, rename variable, data type, description, and measure. Now remember, whenever you are bringing data in, you cannot use column names which has got special characters like comma, full stop. So this is the place that you correct those and give names which you want and which StatCraft supports. Moreover, you only choose the fields that you need and drop the ones that you don't. See, for example, there is a field which seems to contain not too much of information. The variable name is given in blank quotes, and I don't want, because it looks like some junk data. So what I'll do is I'll switch this field off by just clicking here, and as you can see, the green tick changes into a red cross. So this is the field that I do not want. I can go over here into this column, which is rename variable, and start renaming that, because you see they're marked in red, which means it probably uses some special characters which StatCraft doesn't support. And if I have to tell you, if you see the original field name is sepal dot length, and now here this is not allowed. So what I'll do is I will go and change it to sepal. So let me first delete it. So what I'll do is I'll change this to sepal underscore length. And you will see that the red coloring turns into black. Means this is a supported field name. Let me do this with the balance. I will just replace the dot with an underscore. Okay, it's not taken for some reason. There are two quote marks which I need to get rid of. So there it goes, and here you have something which is supported. So let me get rid of these quote marks over here. This is a great place to actually start renaming your data set and then replacing them with names which are more intelligent or which something that you prefer. for future reference or for readability. So let me remove all this. Here you have all the field names coming in black, which means they are supported. Now here is another column, it's called data type. Now here what you can do is you can change the data type. You know, for example, species is a string, so if you want, you can change it to something else. It will not change because, you know, you cannot change string into numeric. But here, if you wanted to, you could have changed this numeric value into a string value. Let's leave it as they are right now because we do not want to make any changes. You have a description field also where you can start typing in the descriptions of what you have taken. So you can say iris, sepal length, length, and then let's just do a couple of them to save time. Iris, sepal, width. Now the advantage of doing this is that when you are actually doing an analysis, so instead of your very bare bones kind of a field name, you will get these descriptions whenever you are doing a chart or a table. And here is another column marked measure, and there you can actually change the data type, you know, from scale to nominal, scale to ordinal, ordinal to nominal, whatever you would like. So for example, if I click here, you will get three values: scale, nominal, and ordinal. So we'll leave it a scale because we know that sepal length is a scale value. You have species which is a nominal value. If I wanted to do, I would could have changed it to ordinal. Okay, it is not, so we leave it at nominal itself. Okay, so once you have done, we click OK, and we get a message bar saying it is 100% completed, and take a bit of a time, and then we are back into the initial data screen, and you can see all the names of the fields that you imported in. So that is about all. You take this and we are ready to go. Quick small things. You know that you had given some descriptions, and if you actually want those descriptions to come at the top of the columns rather than the original variable names, click on this particular icon and you can see these two variable names, or rather two variable descriptions that you have typed in, are now coming as column headers rather than the bare name of the variable. So that is about all. Thanks folks for watching this video. Keep watching this space, and we'll come back with more videos to help you get started with StatCraft. Thank you once more.